Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you the basics of using drag and drop on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So drag and drop is one of the most basic skills that you need to master to use your Mac. Basically, you're going to move your pointer to an item, like a file here in the Finder, and then you're going to click and continue to hold down on the trackpad or mouse. Then you can move and the item will move with the pointer. Then you move it to the location where you want it to go and release your finger on the trackpad or mouse. This is a drag and drop. So this is the most basic example, to move a file from one location to another using two Finder windows. You can also drag and drop within a single Finder window. So if I wanted to move that same file into this folder, I can simply drag it into that folder. There's a lot that goes on that can help you when you're dragging and dropping. For instance, if I were to do that again but hesitate above this folder, it would eventually open up. This is called spring loading. And now I'm in that folder. And I can move down even further into another folder and then drop the file in there. But you can also drag and drop to other locations. For instance, you have all these locations in the Finder sidebar. You can drag and drop to one of those as well. You could also select multiple items and drag them at the same time. The way to do that is to use the Command key. Select your first item, then hold the Command key down and select another item. And while you continue to hold the Command key down, you can select several more items. So now I have four items selected. I can now release the Command key and then drag any one of those and all four will come together. So I can move all four of these to another folder. In Icon View, you can also click where there is no item and drag in a rectangle will form. And anything that's under the rectangle will be selected. So I can select a whole group of files like this and then drag and drop that group. This works in other Finder views as well. So let's switch from Icon View to List View. And here we can see the files in List View and I could select one and drag it into a folder, drag it to another Finder window. I can select multiple ones using the Command key just like before. I could also select a file and then use the Shift key and it will select a range in either list or column view. And then I could drag that whole group. But moving files around is just the beginning. You can also drag a file or other type of item onto something to perform an action. For instance, in the second Finder window here, I'm going to go to the Applications folder. So now I see a list of all my applications. I can open a file in an application by simply dragging and dropping it to that application. So here you could see Pages. I can take this text document and drag and drop it onto Pages and it will open it up in Pages. But usually you don't open the Applications folder for that. Instead, you use the dock at the bottom. So you can drag a file like this to one of these icons for an application and it will open it up in that application. Now only the applications that support that kind of file will work. So for instance, TextEdit will work, and Pages will work, and other apps that you have that will take text files like the Notes app will work as well. Now it's really handy when you have documents that can be opened by multiple apps. For instance, you may have an image file and you can open an image file in Preview, but also you may have an app like Pixelmator Pro, Acorn, or Affinity Photo. If you double click, it will only open it up in the default app. But if you drag and drop to that app in the dock, then you can select the app each time you open the document. And different apps deal with the document in different ways. For instance, let's drag this image file here into the Mail app. What it's going to do then is open up a new composition window, put the image there as an attachment. So Mail handles it differently than, say, an image editing app. Now you can also drag files into the document windows for other apps. So for instance, here I am in Pages and I have a document open. If I want to insert an image in this document, I can simply drag the image directly into the document and it will insert it in there. The same thing works in Mail. If I'm composing a message, I can drag and drop an image into the message. And in the Messages app here, right in the middle of a conversation, I could drag and drop an image right to the message area there and it inserts it in. But this also works going from app to app. So here I've got the Photos app and I can browse through all my photos. And then here I've got Mail. I'm composing a message. I can drag and drop a photo directly from the Photos app into a Mail composition window and it inserts the image in there. I didn't have to export it from Photos first and then take that file and attach it. And you can see that works in Messages as well. I can drag right from Photos into Messages. You can drag and drop from Photos to the Finder to export a photo. But you can also drag and drop a file from the Finder into Photos to import it. Inside of apps you can drag and drop things. So here I am in the Photos app. If I wanted to add a photo to an album here in the sidebar, I can drag and drop the photo right to the album. Likewise, in the Music app, I can drag and drop a song into a playlist. And in the Mail app, I can drag and drop a message like this one into a mailbox or a folder. In Preview, when you're viewing a PDF, you can bring up the thumbnails in the sidebar here, and you can move pages around by dragging and dropping the pages to change the order. I can even drag and drop a PDF file into another PDF file, adding it right here as a page inside this document. Or if I open up the document here, view the thumbnails, I can drag and drop a page from one to the other. To move documents around inside of PDF documents, all with just drag and drop. Now you can move content inside of documents around with drag and drop as well. So for instance, I can take some text here inside of a Pages document. Once I've selected it, I can click and then drag that text and move it somewhere else in the document. But I could also drag and drop it into another document, or even drag and drop text between apps. So here I'm going to drag and drop this piece of text from a Pages document into an email. And I'm still only just scratching the surface. You can use drag and drop for so much. Anytime you have an object, an item, or some content that you want to do something with, consider what would happen if you were to select it and then drag it onto something or into something. Would that seem to accomplish what you want? If so, then give it a try. Different apps support drag and drop at different levels, so sometimes it may work and solve your problem without you having to search for a menu item, command, or a special function. Here's some other places where drag and drop is the solution. In the dock, you have all these different apps. If you want to rearrange them, simply click and drag and drop them into a new location. And if you launch an app that's not even here, like I'll launch Chess, it'll appear on the right side. But if I want to make it a permanent part of the dock, I can simply drag it from the right side to the left, and now it'll stay there in the dock even when I've quit the app. And if I want to remove it, all I need to do is drag and drop it up, and you can see the little remove label. Now I drop it there and it's gone from the dock. All that's done simply with drag and drop. Even the menu bar icons here could be rearranged and removed using drag and drop, but you have to hold the command key down, and then you could drag and reorder these, or drag them down to remove them. If you ever want to rearrange items in the sidebar here, you can do that using drag and drop. It works here in the Finder. It'll work, say, in Photos, moving your albums around. It'll work in Mail, moving your mailboxes up and down. In Launchpad, you can rearrange the apps by dragging and dropping them and moving them around, or you can drop one on top of the other to create a folder for several apps. You can drag and drop events in the calendar app. So here I have a lunch scheduled. I can drag and drop it to another day. In the Reminders app, I can drag and drop reminders to rearrange them or to move them to other reminders lists. Sometimes it's tricky to drag something because if I were to click here, it will check the dot. If I were to click here, I'm editing the text. So I have to find a spot that's outside of all of that, like right here, to then drag and drop the entire thing as an item. So here's one last tip. If you were to drag and drop a file from one location of the Finder to another, it will move that file. You can see it's gone from here and now it appears here. But if you want to copy it instead, while dragging and dropping, hold the Option key down and you can see you get the little green plus. And now the original stays there and a copy is in the new location. On the other hand, if you're moving from one drive to another, then by default it will copy. You can see here a plus because I'm moving it from the internal drive to this external drive. If you do want to move it, then hold the Command key down and the plus goes away. And then you can actually move it, deleting the first copy and only having the second copy when it's done. So you can see how important it is on a Mac to master drag and drop. So many things that we do, like moving items, rearranging items, exporting and importing, is all done using drag and drop. So get good at using it and you'll be good at using your Mac. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.